space and software, reliability and security. I've been working on few of the mobile interception devices, and I came to know that most of the people think that voice calls are the ones which are being monitored. It's the opposite way. Most of the SMS, in fact 100% of the SMS are being monitored, because for intercepting a voice call, particular channels have to be selected. While for intercepting any SMS, no channel has to be selected. All the SMS of each and every user in that area of 25 kilometers are being recorded in the database. So with this as the aim, we thought of developing this mobile app, and it also has facility for storing all the files in a hidden way. A password lock is provided for that. It has some additional features also, which I will be telling you. SMS transmission, like, it is the easiest way of interception, this I have already told you. Then there are certain encryption algorithms that we have been using in this, and we have also provided few of the techniques for the user itself to select the algorithm. And the protection is provided on the basis of password, a mutually agreed upon password between the users. All those users who are having this particular application may have some policies for password protection, and they may have designed certain techniques of their own. So there is no need of a common password. Each and every user can have multiple passwords or multiple type of SMS based on the requirement, based on the location. And there are 6 encryption algorithms which have been provided, and the user can select which kind of algorithm he or she wants to use. Then there are certain other techniques of encryption, decryption using the compression and decompression, so as to minimize the size of the text message being sent. Thereafter, additional features that have been provided are for hiding the files and folders in your mobile using a password, integration with inbuilt GPS to find out own location, then secure transfer of own location using the encrypted message, and integration of own location plus the location of all the users who have been sending you their own locations through SMS. That can be seen on the Google Maps. Next, I will be giving you a demo of this. This is the app RDS strategy, Live Data Security. It came from this, and this is flash screen just for 2-3 seconds. Now here you can see, this is a password. Enter password, this is a text box. To enter, this is an authenticated access. To enter into the in this application, you need to enter the password. For sending SMS, you just enter, and you have a checkbox for send location. That is, it will take into account all your present location using the inbuilt GPS. As this way, it has taken only, automatically it has taken one location plus the message, whatever you type. So both gets appended, and you have you can select using the contact list. This is again a seamless integrated feature of the Android itself that has been integrated into this. And once you keep on send this message, then a pop-up pops up. Then to read SMS, again you have to enter the password. If you enter read SMS without entering the password, you will see nothing. All jargon as you see here. 7 minutes later. Now to read this SMS, you again have to go through the you again have to enter the password, and then after you go on to read SMS. I think some password error entered. I think it must be some typing error, I guess. Well, next, which is show location. This is the own location which is displayed on Google Map. And I am again working on it ahead. As I told you that all the SMS that you receive, their locations is fed into a CSV file or a text file, and those locations are picked up from there, and you have complete awareness of your entire circle as to where each and every person is located. Then hide the hide folder. This is the entire list of files and folders is displayed here. As you see, screen has again a password field. You enter a password and select a file. Enter a password, select a file, and there's a lock button.
Okay, guys, you're out of time. Thank you.
So this way, you can lock all your files and folders. This is actually a complete package. Thank you.
So this requires that both parties have your application.
Sorry?
This requires that both parties have your application. What if you want to send to somebody who just to you anything? You trigger the recipient to also install the application if you send an encrypted message first time?
All the users that are having a special application, all the users having this application will be able to read it. And the users who are requesting for this application, we have two methods. One is we are still working on it. Till now, what I was thinking is that we can have a IMEI specific installation of this app. So it will be, and we have already implemented it. Right now, it works only on those devices which we have already fed into and hard programmed with, hard coded it.
Hi. Excuse me, I got a question. So there was a password error or misconception over. If by any case I forget my password, then what do you do?
It's just like you forget key of your lock. But anyway, you can have another key also. Similarly, if I forget the password usually shared between me and you, then we can again get into some other password.
So I should share the password with another contact?
No. Like if we want to have communication between us in an encrypted way and we have this application stored, then we both have a mutually shared one password.
Right. And we can have the same mechanism. If we forgot our password, then we can set some other authentication, like email system or something, where we can send.
Certain policies can be designed based on date, time, place, whatever.
In your presentation, you mentioned you are giving an action to the user itself to select.
Yeah, I have not demonstrated, but we are planning. We have already included 6 of the algorithms.
So what is that I need to give?
Certain groups may require that this is a general application and everyone is using the same encryption algorithm. So my group of 100 people, we don't want to use this application. It can be used for sharing your credit card details, your bank passwords, or you want to give your details to someone, some confidential data. It can be used for tracking your kids, for tracking the event parties, for picnic parties, and for weather security forces. So many things are there. So each and every group may like to have their own algorithm. And in fact, they can devise their own algorithm. The same text can be put into their own algorithm. You just pick and drop into that particular method.
And then we can share other information which is already encrypted and stored in our like. Just click on the show
option, you can have like signed bank details or signed email. Just already encrypted. I mean, stored in our mobile. Just click and then sign it. So it's encrypted in our system. It is already encrypted on the receiver side and it's encrypted on the network.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah. The app look great on our side, but question is, see the people sitting over here. They understand encryption, they understand whatever. And the app UI, I see that there are 6 buttons saying, when I want to send a message, I need to select an encryption algorithm. How many of these laymen understand encryption, understand algorithm, and why do I worry about it? You should have done this in the back. It should have been done behind the scenes. It shouldn't be exposed to the user. So the user experience is not really good on this app. What do you think about it?
Yeah, very relevant question. If you see, I told you about giving 6 options, but I have not shown them. It's because I will be giving this option to the administrator of a particular group. That administrator of the group will select the algorithm he wants to choose for his own 100 people. Here I have not shown you those 6 algorithm methods to choose. I have just shown you the actual application that will be delivered to the user. That's okay.
This application, in that scenario, more useful.
Police Indian Army security forces, banks, banks, all critical confidential data.
Because they have their own algorithm as well. So if they want to apply their algorithm, they can, we have extension
to support select. Another.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Next year, Joe, after here.